the diabetic population, if you have a poorly controlled diabetes and the duration is more than 10 years, that's when the metabolic changes of diabetes kick in, by and large.
Sure.
So the metabolic changes are the ones which cause the blood vessels in the retina to start changing their structure in terms of the permeability of the vessel wall.
Sure.
And that's where the leakages of fluid, serum, blood happen, and the retinopathy kicks in. As far as cataract is concerned, another common problem, anything which causes high blood sugar and fluctuates it, and the metabolic changes related to up and down blood sugar every now and then, and consistently high blood sugar, will cause a cataract also. So cataracts can even kick in much before 10 years if the sugar, if the sugar is high enough or fluctuant enough.
You know, diabetics know one thing, that, you know, when their blood sugar is high, their vision goes down, and when the blood sugar becomes normal, it becomes crystal clear.
That's because of the lens changes, refractive changes. The refractive index of the lens changes when the sugar is
altered.
So some waterlogging will lead to a change in the refraction.
And how many diabetics actually, or rather people who are supposedly healthy, come here and find out that they have diabetes because you check the retina and find, and you get suspicious that
You do see a fairly decent percentage that, you know, who are first detected in the ophthalmologist chamber, you know, with the kind of hemorrhagic retina or a macular edema. They first come in with these problems, not knowing that they have diabetes, and they have ignored it for so many years. And then suddenly, you, when you check it out, a diabetic macular edema, you have a patient who has a freshly detected diabetes on you, on your hand.
And doctor, now, when it comes to glaucoma, diabetes are more prone to glaucoma?
Not really. You may have diabetes, but it's not associated with glaucoma. Primary, or, you know, I'm not talking about primary glaucoma. Secondary glaucoma, yes, diabetics, proliferative diabetic retinopathy, neovascular glaucoma, new blood vessels formation. So secondary glaucoma is associated, but not primary glaucoma.
Doctor, can you explain what is this primary and what
primary is that something that you are destined to get, like, you know, age related.
Okay.
So if you have glaucoma in the family, there's a high propensity of patients developing glaucoma. That is open angle, where the angle or drainage mechanism is open.
Yes.
There is another entity known as closed angle glaucoma or narrow angle glaucoma, where the drainage mechanism is narrowed down, but because the drainage mechanism narrowed down doesn't mean that, you know, it's a secondary glaucoma, it's a primary glaucoma, where the anatomy of the eye is such that the structure is made that way. It's a narrow angle, so it can close down. So that's a narrow angle or a closed angle glaucoma.
And what is the secondary glaucoma?
The secondary glaucoma are glaucoma related to other conditions in the eye. Say a hemorrhage, an injury, or a uveitis that leads to high pressure.
Okay.
So these are classified as secondary.
The other email talks about tunnel vision. Is that a part of glaucoma?
Yes. Advanced glaucoma.
Oh.
Very advanced glaucoma. It leads to tunnel vision. Initially, the side vision gets affected in small pockets or in kind of an arcuate field loss, which is like a crescentic kind of field loss. But over time, the vision from the periphery starts shrinking, and eventually, in the end stage glaucoma, you're left with just a tunnel, which is the central 10 degrees, 20 degrees or so. And that can also shut down in case the glaucoma is not corrected.
Doctor, you know, there are very well-known ophthalmologists like Dr. Natarajan who would say that as long as you can perceive light, you can be treated for blindness. Do you also believe that?
Yes, I agree with that. Because if you can see light, there is still some element of hope. Because even though you may have kind of such poor vision, which is possibly not easy to kind of improve, but an attempt should be made to improve it. Because God forbid if something happens to the fellow eye and you've not done anything for the bad eye, then you have lost everything.
Both of them.
So it's an attempt to definitely try to push the limits so that you try to recover as much as possible in any blind eye which is still seeing light.
Very true. Doctor, why does it happen that, you know, when it comes to nephropathy, most patients lose both their kidney, but when it comes to retinopathy, the diabetics don't lose both at the same time? Most of the cases, you know...
It can happen that, you know, one may be slower, one may be little more advanced. So the slower eye will have less advanced disease. But eventually, with time, both the eyes do get affected.
I see.
And some of them can be equally severe.
Oh.
Yeah, some of them can be equally severe.
Let's get to two issues which are very typical for diabetics, that is macular edema and retinopathy. Doctor, in case of retinopathy, how much is the chance, if somebody has already got a little bit of retinopathy, because that's where most people write to us. It's not that they are trying to prevent retinopathy. Most of them have cases of retinopathy and they want to avoid future damage. In such cases, what is actually your prescription? In the sense, what kind of diet should they follow? What kind of regimen they should follow?
Well, control of diabetes is the major factor in preventing
further
damage from occurring.
Okay.
So that is very important. I mean, with the help of the diabetologist, the control should be properly maintained. Diet, of course, plays its own role in the overall control. So one should not get tempted to sort of, you know, take things which are likely to aggravate the blood sugar. Having said that, it's easier said than done, you know. So it's a kind of battle which the patient actually takes home every day and trying to control the diabetes. So if there is a retinopathy developing, you know, in order to prevent further damage, checkups every now and then and laser or anti-VEGFs if required for diabetic macular edema are the mainstay at the moment. And of course, good control will definitely go a long way in preventing further damage.
This anti-VEGF is basically the injection which has come new.
Yeah.
Okay. And that has shown a lot of promise.
Yeah. It does show a lot of promise, but it's currently, I feel, being overused. You know, so they're using it for anything and everything. And also, there's a fair amount of commercial weightage to the procedure. So that actually, you know, is a little undesirable. When needed...
You say it's used even for non-retinopathy cases?
Yeah, for other cases also. Like, you know, new blood vessel formation, but that's an advancement. Like, in the sense, initially started off for diabetics and then macular edemas, and
sure,
now the indications have expanded. But it's a very promising field, no doubt.
But doctor, you know, it's always very confusing. These new blood vessels which are made, is it nature's way of keeping that organ alive? Isn't that true?
But those new blood vessels are more prone to bleeding.
Absolutely.
So they are not normal blood vessels. So therefore they need to be regressed and
okay,
before they cause further damage. Because one bleed and if your macula is fired, then it
sure
takes a long time to recover.
Sure, very true. Doctor, there is also the controversy around hypertension, if that can actually become worse for a diabetic who is suffering from retinopathy. You know, there are reports which says there is absolutely no connection yet. And there are doctors who would say there is a connection.
There is definitely a connection because both are causing a synergy in damaging further.
Bleeding and all that.
Yeah. Because when the blood vessels are further aggravated with the high blood pressure, And anyway, if you have a diabetic retinopathy with new blood vessel formation, any spike in blood pressure is going to lead to easier blood loss in the eye, you know, easier rupture.